okay, and as well as here the HCO3-, and I am taking here the ammonia NH3. Okay, so for this one I want to explain what is the conjugate acid, what is the conjugate base. Okay, so first of all, conjugate acid is always came from here the accepting of which one here, the proton. Accepting of proton. Okay, that means for the H2O, what is the conjugate acid here? The H3O plus. Okay, next of all, for HSO4 minus, accepting of the H plus ion, it is nothing but H2SO4. And for this one, you can write H2CO3. And for this one, you can write NH4 plus. Okay, and for this one, I want to explain conjugate base. What it is here, the conjugate base. So for the conjugate base, always conjugate base is formed by which one here, the losing of protons. So whenever the proton is loses, so what are the ions are here, the OH minus, and already it has HSO4 minus. Whenever it loses the H plus ion, you can write here the SO4 minus 2, and it loses the H plus ion, it will here the CO3 minus 2, and it will be KNH2 minus. Okay, these are all are differ by only one H plus ion. So these pairs are called as the conjugate acid base pair. Okay, so it is the second acid base theory. First one, Arrhenius acid base theory, we are completed. Second one, Brandt's acid base theory. It is always explained the conjugate acid base pairs. So I am giving here the example for this one. Only third theory, that is nothing but Lewis. Which one here? The Lewis acid base theory. Third theory, what it is here, the Lewis acid base theory. Okay, so Lewis acid base theory, in this one also acid and as well as here the base. I can give for the definition Lewis acid. It is depends upon the electron pairs. Okay, it depends upon which one here, the electron pairs. Okay, Arrhenius acid base theory depends upon the compound dissolving in water. Brandsted acid base theory depends upon here the protons. Lewis acid base theory depends upon here the electron pair. Okay, so Lewis acid is nothing but acceptor of electron pair. What it is here, the acceptor of electron pair. So that is called as here Lewis acid. Okay, so next of all, base, Lewis base, what will be here, donor of, what it is here, the donor of electron pair. Donor of electron pair is called as here the base. Lewis acid base theory, Lewis acid is nothing but the group which can accept the electron pair, that is called as Lewis acid. Lewis base is nothing but the group which can donates electron pair, that is called as here the base, Lewis base. Example for the Lewis acids here, okay, all electron deficient compounds. Example for this one, what it is here, the all electron deficient compounds. Those are best example for which one here, the Lewis acid. What is the meaning of electron deficient? Is the electron density which can have the less, those are called as here the electron deficient compounds. Example, those which are having the empty d orbitals, those which are having the positive charge, that means all cations, and as well as those which are having here the density should be here the less. Okay, so those are considered as here the Lewis acid. Next one, Lewis base, these are the electron deficient compound, and Lewis bases are here the electron rich compounds. The compounds which are having electron rich is nothing but electron density is more, those are considered as here the Lewis bases. Example for this one here, the electron rich compounds. What are those here? The electron rich compounds are considered as here the Lewis bases. Okay, and also negative charge. Negative charge also indicates the more number of electrons are present. That means we can also say as anions. For this one, cations, electron deficient, empty d orbital containing. For this one, electron rich, minus charge is nothing but anion, and which can has here the lone pair of electrons. Okay, and as well has here the anions. Those are belongs to here the Lewis bases. Okay, so for the introduction in the acid base, we are completed how many theories here? The theories, number one, Arrhenius theory, number two, Brandsted theory, number three, here the Lewis acid base theory. Okay, so next I can entering into here the topic. Okay, so in this topic, next one is here the ionic product of water. Next one, what it is here? The ionic product of water. Ionic product of water. Okay, it indicated with which one here? The KW, ionic product of water. So the definition of this one is the product of concentrations of H plus ion and as well as here the OH minus ion. So those are called as here the, that is called as here the ionic product of water. So whenever we are taking the water involves in the equilibrium, we can write here the H plus OH minus, H plus and as well as here the OH minus. So now for this one, we have to write what it is here, the KW. KW is, it is nothing but the product of concentration of H plus ion and as well as here the OH minus ion. Okay. Next of all, ionic product of water always depends upon here the temperature. It always depends upon here the temperature. At 25 degrees centigrade, the KW value is here 10 to the power of minus 14 mole square per liter square. Okay, what is the value of ionic product to water at 25 degrees centigrade? KW is equal to what it is here, 10 to the power of minus 14 mole square per liter square. Okay, so next of all, I want to explain here the, for example, I am taking here the neutral solution. I am taking which one here? The neutral solutions. So for the neutral solution, always the concentration of H plus ion is equal to the concentration of OH minus ion. Okay, so for neutral solutions, the concentration of H plus ion is always equal to here the OH minus. Okay, so that's why we can write here the normally KW is equal to concentration of H plus ion into concentration of OH minus ion. In the place of OH minus ion, I can write the H plus. So what will be here, the KW is equal to H plus into, again also we can write here the H plus. So from this one we can write here the KW is equal to H plus to the power of 2. Okay, so from this one we can write here the H plus ion is equal to under root of KW. Okay, what is the normal value of KW here? The 10 to the power of minus 14. So under root of 10 to the power of minus 14 means here the 10 to the power of minus 7. It is the concentration of H plus ion. It is the concentration of H plus ion. Square root of KW is equal to square root of 10 to the power of minus 14. So what will be the units here? The 10 to the power of minus 7 mole per liter. 10 to the power of minus 7 moles per liter. Next of all, so why we have to discuss about the H plus concentration? In the acid basis concept, compulsory we have to depend one important terminology. What it is called as here? The pH. What it is called as? pH. So what is the definition of the pH here? The what is the definition of the pH? It is nothing but it tells about the concentration of H plus ions and as well as the concentrations of OH minus, that should be explained by the POH. Based upon the pH also we have to differentiate what is the acid, what is the base, what is the neutral solution. So for pH, I can give the mathematical equation. pH is equal to minus logarithm of base 10 square bracket of H plus. So it should be called as the mathematical equation for the pH. Okay, for this one we can write H plus ion concentration, what will be here? The 10 to the power of minus pH. What it is here? The 10 to the power of minus pH. And what about the POH? POH is nothing but the minus logarithm of square bracket of OH minus. So from this one we can write the OH minus concentration is equal to 10 to the power of minus POH. Okay, so now here based upon the pH we can say that one, whenever the pH value is less than 7, pH value is here the less than 7, so that should be called as here the acid. Next of all, pH is more than 7, that should be called as here the base. If the pH is equal to 7, that should be called as here the neutral. What it is called as here the neutral. Okay, so whenever we are drawing, it is our pH scale, it is our 7. These are all are considered as here the acids, and these are here it is the 14. So these are called as here the bases. Okay, so it is the introduction about the pH and as well as here the pOH. So based upon this one, we are also some of the problems are there. Okay, so next of all, we have to give the how, why the pH scale possesses here the 14 units only. Okay, based upon the ionic product of water, we can also prove that one.